Good morning, everyone. The MMDAR back on the road. This is Task Force Special Operations Alpha Group. Right now, they're issuing tickets to illegally parked vehicles. Priority today is around the bus terminals because it's coming up to Christmas. As mentioned recently, the MMDAR are not towing cars anymore. So if there's no driver, they just put the ticket on the windshield. The ticket can be anywhere from 200 pesos to 500 pesos, although in the future, that will increase. You'll see that there are signs along the road. For instance, that one over there, no parking both sides. And the team just issued a ticket to this truck here. In fact, this is the same place they saw trucks parked last time. Problem is, this is a two-way road. So what happens later is when all the buses come down here, it gets heavily congested because it's limited to a one-lane road. So they issued a ticket and they're asking them to move the truck away from the area now. Again, there are signs, for example, here, says no parking both sides. And aside from illegal parking, they're also looking at things like this, a young school child on the back of a motorcycle without a helmet. The man said he already has a ticket, but even if he does, at that point he should stop and then find alternative means of transport or find a helmet. There's another guy here, no helmet. And although he said he had a ticket already, it looks like he doesn't, so I'm not sure where that came from. And yes, they are also issuing a ticket to that man that came in the background, no helmet. And across the road, they're issuing tickets to these taxis parked here eating. The sidewalks are partially obstructed by the eateries. You can see, for example, these tables and chairs are actually on the sidewalk. And then when people sit here, of course, they occupy more space, and then people start walking in the road, except they can't walk in the road because it's obstructed by taxis, so then they end up walking here. You see the guys are coming in now and they'll be confiscating these items to clear the sidewalk. Like mentioned before, the sidewalk is really designed for pedestrians. It's not designed for businesses. Now, what they'll usually do the first time is give them a warning. But if they keep coming back and keep seeing the same things, that's the point that they start confiscating. And here comes a table from further down the street because it has the same issue with eateries built on the sidewalk. Now, of course, in this case, not only was the sidewalk being blocked for pedestrians, but vehicles were stopping here and parking to eat. So that was the secondary problem. So hopefully by clearing this, they'll alleviate traffic in this area and make the road and the sidewalk a little bit safer for pedestrians. As always, they're letting them keep the goods that they're selling, but all of the furniture, the umbrellas, the chairs, the tables, stuff like that is going on the back of the truck. Now, some people might say, okay, you're protecting pedestrians, you're reducing traffic, but how about the livelihood of the vendors? Well, they appear to live just there. So if they knock down this wall and then put the canteen behind, there won't be any problem. The only reason why the MMDA are looking at this is because this is a sidewalk. And over here, they're gonna stop this motorcycle. You can see there's a lady on the back, no helmet. They won't stop him before he enters a private property because it would be very hard to ticket him if they let him go inside. They'll just help him unload his bananas and then ask for the license and issue a ticket, although he's still trying to walk away. Again, they're preventing the bike from going inside. We have seen it before where once people get inside private property, they'll lock the gates, they'll lock the doors, and they'll hide from enforcers, and then they have to call police, and it becomes a very big, it takes a long time. So it's best if they prevent people and keep them here on the road. You can see over here, one of the enforcers is taking pictures of these two tricycles on the sidewalk. That's why these people are walking in the road right now. So he's just writing out the tickets now, and hopefully they'll be moved on. And further down the road, they're looking at this van and another van behind it, obstructing what should be the sidewalk. A lot of pedestrians have been going past in the road, so they're just going to issue tickets and then ask them to move the vans. And then they'll also clear things like this, signs are obstructing the sidewalk, and this, probably this table here also. But now they're going on the back. It appears to be some kind of business that was operating here. That's why there were so many obstructions. But as mentioned earlier, the sidewalk is for pedestrians, not for businesses. And as always, they're taking a detailed log of everything that's confiscated. You can see it goes back many, many pages. In fact, I think this is a new book because the book I saw before was much thicker than this. So they do keep detailed records. Here's another common problem that you come across. The sidewalk is quite narrow anyway. I'm sure at one point it was wider. And then when you get this far, you can see it's completely obstructed by plants. It is nice to see plants around the city, but when it forces pedestrians in the road where they might get hit by vehicles, it's not so nice. I'm not sure about this specific road, but in some parts of Cabal, for example, you see the sidewalk is so narrow, and then when you get to someone's gate, you look inside and you can actually see the original sidewalk still inside their property. And what's happened is over the years they've extended their wall, extended their gate. Like I said, I'm not sure about this road, but I'd be surprised if the sidewalk was originally this narrow. Over here they're looking at this, some kind of rolling carton left on the sidewalk. Again, you'll notice that everyone's walking in the road because of these obstructions. So there is a reason behind all of this. And right now one of the enforcers is issuing a ticket to this truck parked here. It's a concrete truck. I think it's for the construction that's going on way, way, way down there that we saw before. They're still asking for the license and they're pointing out the sign that's right here, no parking this side. The driver's saying they have a permit, but I very much doubt they have any kind of permit that overrides the sign here. They have the license now, so they'll just issue the ticket and then ask him to move on. The team are now on 14th Avenue. You can see in the distance there a sign that says park along this side only. So it's one side parking on that side. Any vehicle parked on this side will be issued a ticket. And although parking is allowed on this side of the road, it shouldn't obstruct the sidewalk like this one. So they just took a picture now and they'll be issuing a ticket. And same with this one here, you can see it's partially on the sidewalk. So again, they'll issue a ticket. You can see the enforcers just there. And you'll see over here, they've stopped one more motorcycle rider. Very nice bike, but unfortunately no helmet. So that's a 1,500 peso penalty. It's quite a heavy penalty. Oh, he has a helmet, but it's on his elbow. Actually, it's more than just no helmet. This is a one-way road and the guy is going the wrong way. So that's counterflow. That's 2,000 pesos and 2 months suspension of driver's license. And what you might notice over here is that someone's actually taken one of the MMDA signs and they put a bike lock around it and placed it here. This is very misleading because parking is allowed on this side. It's the other side where it's not allowed. And this is a government-owned sign. You're not allowed to remove this. It's against the law. And you're not meant to, you know, put it somewhere else and make it look like, oh, that's no parking. I would assume that whoever put it here has put it here to try and reserve this space so that people see this and think, oh, I better not park there. But I can hear them now. They're calling in the sidewalk clearing team to remove this. Looks like they've got another sign here also in the bushes. Maybe they're doing a collection of no parking signs. Further down the road, these two vehicles have tickets on the windshield. There's no towing, so they could be here for the rest of the day, but they do have tickets at least. And here's another difficulty related to no towing. This tricycle only has half a plate. It's been ripped off or broken off, so they can't write out a ticket because you don't have the first few digits of the license plate number. And what's very common with tricycles and motorcycles is that they don't have any plate at all. They just say for registration. And if you come across a vehicle like that, there's really nothing you can do. What they might do is call in a tow truck specially just for this. Further down the road, they removed this roof and some chairs and tables from the sidewalk. The Sari Sari store is private property, so no problem. But the sidewalk itself is obviously public property for pedestrians, so that's why they're clearing it. And just along from that store, they're issuing a ticket to this motorcycle on the sidewalk. It's no parking, of course. Someone was about to ride it away, but he said if you don't have a license, don't ride it, just push it. So they'll issue the ticket to the plate number and then let them push it away. And further down, you can see they're taking down this, I don't know what this is, like a bench or something. There was also a little table here. Again, Sari Sari store, no problem, but once you start extending over the sidewalk, that's when they're gonna deconstruct it. Over here, they stopped this motorcycle. Unfortunately, two riders, no helmets, plus a blinking brake light, which isn't allowed. And a little bit further along, excess passenger, a small baby with no helmet. Very dangerous to have babies on motorcycles anyway. And over here you can see a grill is going on the back of the sidewalk clearing truck. The MMDA will clear it. I'm not sure about those at the local level, but the MMDA will clear it. This man here said he'll be taking a picture of them and reporting them to the barangay captain. Some of the residents have been complaining, hey, it's not a major road, and so on and so on. The thing is, the MMDA are working on a complaint that's gone to their office. Bad luck for this motorcycle rider. He's just been stopped driving against the flow of traffic. And it looks like things just got worse for that rider because apparently he can't show a driver's license either. Okay, when they said they'll call in a tow truck to take away the bike, he found his license. So no problem, they'll just issue a ticket, but that is 2,000 pesos and 3 months suspension of driver's license.